you. Thank you all for just inviting me out and giving me the opportunity to speak about Twist. I really appreciate you, and I love that you all are doing positive exposure of people in the community versus whatever else you could be doing.
Yeah.
I appreciate you shedding a positive light in the world.
For sure.
So.
You know, stylish, she say I'm childish. I say I'm Beano, she better eyelids. Flying four planes, cameras with no wings. I'm four pilots. I ain't gotta put my AC on full blast. I feel I'm colder than what come out of my vehicle. Toastmaster, get filled, my dermatologist. Speech therapist told me I'ma let you still silence. On the road to success, fuck how I drift. I can't lose, I've been on four diets. It's gonna look like a Kim K. Rose 38, but I got left a lot more mileage. Matter of fact, you ain't straight, make me do it. Here's a link in my bio. Nigga, go buy this. A rash visa promise my next project. You gon' think a nigga has spit it through the wire.
Bruh. A1 MCs in the place to be, you know, always bringing y'all the best, the freshest, and man, hey man, today, man, we got a dope brother, man. I had a chance to check out some of his works and some of his music, and you know, man, you know, you never know who coming through the A1 studios, man. Today, man, I got the problem, you know what I'm saying? Dogs in the building, what's up, baby?
What go down, man?
Hey, man, first of all, man, I appreciate you for coming through, man.
I appreciate you. Thank you for allowing me to come through on the platform. I really appreciate it,
hey,
man.
Hey, man, most definitely. Well, you know, at Action Win, like, we're all about supporting independent artists and entrepreneurs just because we understand the grind.
Yeah.
And, you know, we recognize that there's so much talent out there that, unfortunately, you know, some of these gatekeepers in the media industry, you know, want to make boys, you know, pay and
already
jump
know.
Through loops and, you know what I'm saying, kiss bud and everything else like that, man. And for us, like, our only motto is just you got to be dope and you got to, you know what I'm saying, be about something. And for me, if I see somebody like that, it's like, all right, man, you know what I'm saying, let's bring them on, man. So, man, let the people know, man, just, you know, introduce yourself, man, you know, where you from, you know, just kind of what are you into?
Dogs to the Problem, man. From the south side of Houston, Texas.
South Acres
to be exact.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just a young brother trying to make it, man. Trying to do this rap thing along with other things. But the rap thing is like my first love. So that's what I'm really trying to make happen.
Most def, man. How long have you been doing music?
I want to say the first time I actually like stepped in the booth and recorded was maybe 2006 or 7. And I did it for a couple of years, and I took a hiatus in 2012. And I just started back in 2017 trying to get familiarized with everything.
Most def, man. You know, you sound like me, man, as far as it go to the music, man. You know what I'm saying? Do it, figure it out, man. But what still motivates you to still, like, content create and write and things like that? Because, you know, you still got to be inspired.
I want to say it's in me. Like, even when I stopped doing it, I was still writing. And I just have a joy of writing. Like, if something comes to mind, whether I'm at work just sitting there or if I'm driving, which I shouldn't be texting and driving, but if I got to pull out my phone and hit the notes, it's just things come to my mind just in rhyme patterns. So I just have a habit of doing it. But just seeing the game and for the city, to be honest, is like I feel like the city is getting better. It's more eyes on us now than it was at one point.
Most definitely.
And it's a good look, even though it's some division within the city, is getting better than what it once was. And I just want to see it get higher. And I want to see Houston back on that mainstream platform.
Man, for sure, man. Man, yeah, man. You one of the ones to do it, man.
Yeah.
I've noticed, man, some of your videos, man, that you know, saying that they're funny, they're cool, man. Yeah. Like, who puts those together, man?
Me, man.
I
mean,
you do it all, man.
Between me and my wife, we the ones. Any video that you've seen is my wife is holding the camera, and I'm the guy that's like, okay, let's go stand over here, let's do it this way, and hold the camera this way, and then I'm editing all the videos. But everything is done by me and my wife.
For sure, man. Man, you got to shout out wifey,
man. I
got to
shout out
the
wifey,
man.
Yeah, she's asleep right now.
Yeah.
Still a shout out.
Sorry, man. She'll catch the replay. You know that? See, man, he was here, man. He was here. I'll vouch for him, man. But now, man, that's alive, man, and that's dope that, man, you keeping it within the fam, man.
Yeah.
But, you know, where can people check out some of your projects that you got out already?
I have music on all streaming platforms, iTunes, Tidal. I stress Tidal because they pay your brother Mo with the streams.
Yeah.
But if you Google me, you'll find stuff. Like I said, I have an EP called Shite, Maybe Do It On all streaming platforms. I have a mixtape I released the same week, which was back in March, that you can find on that pill for mymixtapes.com. I have music videos on YouTube. You can find me there, SoundCloud, Audio Mac. You can find me wherever you can. Just search Dogsta the Problem, you'll find my music.
Most def, man. You know, one thing that, we often talk about and we often hear from artists is them missing out on proper compensation due to, the lack of the business aspect being taken care of. If you could just speak to that a little bit, because, you seem to have your business together,
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm recently learning that stuff. So, within the past year, I went and took a course a year ago. I don't want to say a course. I went to this little seminar thing by Mo Bain Media. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Mo Bain.
Yeah.
But he had the seminar for artists. Well, he was kind of teaching you the business side and give you a handbook and say, hey, make sure you got your stuff copywritten and make sure you went through Sound Exchange to do this, make sure you do that. So before I did, I don't want to say I did it as a hobby or fun. It's always been a love and always been something I wanted to do, but I had more fun with it that I really wasn't on the business side of things.
Right.
So it was just I felt great to be able to put music out and put something out for people to listen to. But now I'm kind of getting more on the business side, too. I'm like, okay, yeah, I need to try to make some money off of this.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm recently learning all of that.
Yeah, nah, that's facts. I mean, I know for me, my learning experience was through missing out.
Yeah.
Through, being a part of projects that have went on, and it's like, ew. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, and that's a lesson learned.
Yeah.
You know?
See, I ain't made it there yet.
because, one thing that, I'm often talking to artists about now is just with the way that, with the way that the film game is going,
yeah.
I feel that we were talking about this the other week that with shout out to Sid about more artists pushing their music towards some of these independent filmmakers and things like that, and they may use it and it just be this underground indie thing, but now with the way Netflix, Amazon, you got five different streaming platforms that are just picking up independent filmmakers. Your music is on there, but then you gotta have your business right,
man.
you gotta have your business right, man. Another thing with the independent artists, man, that a lot of people miss out on, there's a lot of independent artists still, you still gotta grind, still what you do to 9 to 5, man, and family and everything else that, man. How do you keep that balance, man, between family, work, music, everything like that?
It's hard. It ain't easy at all. There's no sleep. It's rest is like the other night. I was up till 4:30. A little after 4:30 in the morning. I had to get right back up at 5:05. So it's those nights where it's no rest, but it just depends on what are you trying to make happen and what are you doing. But I mean, as far as work, I've been at work and can't focus. I'm tired, but it is bad. But I mean, I'm focusing on trying to get out of that situation. Okay. So whatever I got to do on this music side, I got to make happen. But it's hard. I'm doing better, and me venturing out recently, doing a lot, is something new to me and my wife, because we're at one point it was always just us two.
Right.
So wherever I went, she was there. Wherever she was, I was there. But now I was at the point where, okay, I got to go do this music thing. I need to go focus on this or go support such and such. So she's getting, familiar. She's getting used to that side of it. And the kids is like, Daddy, where you going? And I'm like, Daddy got to go do something.
Right,
but
right,
hopefully in the near future, they'll see why Daddy had to do it.
Most def. And, just as we was talking off air, man, you're more than an artist, man.
Correct.
I asked you, about any projects you got going on music-wise, and, you told me that you got something else in the wings for the people, man. Let the people know about that, man.
So I recently released two projects, so I'm kind of focusing on promoting those, but at the same time, I'm not focusing on any new projects in the near future. So right now I have a new show that I'm developing and working on that'll be airing soon on YouTube, where it's giving artists a platform. It's kind of like your Say Cheese CVs. Like the people that's going out interviewing artists is me in one place. And I want to make it like a show. So it's like your Rap City, the Basement, slash your Sway, slash your Joe Budden. It's just me and the artist just chopping it up about different stuff going on. I'm going to play whatever music video you got out that's recent, play the whole music video on that, give you a platform for that. A platform to freestyle, bring it back to the Basement days, and you freestyling over beats, and it's just like a little cool environment. That's what I'm trying to bring.
Oh yeah, man.
But like a full show on YouTube.
Okay, most def, man. That's live, man. We definitely got to link up with you, man, because we got some ciphers and things like that in the winds already, man. So you know we can. We could power up on it, man. You know what I'm saying? And you know, it's always on the south side, man. So you know, I always gotta show love, man. But nah, man, that's dope, man. And for me, I think that's what the culture needs. You know what I'm saying? And it also needs brothers like us. You know what I'm saying? Working together, doing what we need to do. You know, being able to give others, you know what I'm saying, spotlight and praise. And it's like, you know, like everything you just named, that's like what we got going on.
Yeah.
But at the same time, there's enough space out there for everybody, you know what I'm saying, to eat and grow. And like I said, for us to just keep building, because I don't think that can ever be like enough platforms, you know what I'm saying? Especially with just the amount of talent we got here in Houston.
Exactly.
Like, we ain't even talking nowhere else.
And then it's like Houston is so big and you got so many artists on the north side that might be linked to, like, say, not to say that it's like that, but you might have one side of town might be more familiar with you.
Right.
But they don't realize it might be somebody on the other side of town that's doing the same thing. It's
that's fact.
We can all, I don't want to say we can all, but a lot of people can do the same thing.
What's that?
And it won't hurt the city at all. It'll help the city more than what they think. You know what
right. No, no, no. Exactly. Because I think that everybody's going to have something different to bring to the table.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like me and you could interview the same person.
But the style is different.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. And I think that's the main thing. As long as everybody keeps their own originality.
Yeah.
The people going to rock with it because people just want something original.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, you even think about how at one point how it used to be a fight for which morning show you going to listen to. You going to listen to this one, you're listen to that one or whatever.
Yeah.
Now you can hear them all. You can hear Sway, Breakfast Club, yeah. Mad Hatter. Like, you know what I'm saying? You don't even have to choose. You
correct.
Know what I'm saying? And so, you know, I kind of feel the same way, man. But, yeah, man, so man, you got as we wrap up, man. You got anything else going on, man? That you wanna shout out? Go on, man.
Just check out my music if you're able to. Go on, like I said, Tidal, iTunes, Spotify, all those streaming platforms. You can find Shite Made Me Do It, which is a dope EP, 6 tracks. My mixtape Ransomware is out now on Dep Hill for my mixtapes. Just subscribe to me on YouTube. You'll see the different stuff that I'm trying to, you know, get in the works. Whether it's the new show or more music videos that I plan to do. I do plan to do more music videos. I'm just not sure what yet, but just stay tuned, man. I'm working.
Hey, man, we want to make sure that we support you, man. Dogs to the Problem, man. You know what I'm saying? You heard it here first, man. A1 MCs, man. Your brother iTunes Ra. We are A1.com, and we out of here, man. Peace.